workshop. My name is Paula Getty Shear. I'm a certified hypnotherapist. Been doing hypnotherapy since 2004. I have an office in Chatsworth. I also teach a few relaxation classes. One is here every week, every Friday at noon. I want to invite everybody to that. We do meditation, positive affirmations, guided imagery. That's every Friday from noon to one. I'm also at the Foothills in Simi Valley. It's a senior-assisted facility out there. The average age is 87. I go in and do meditation. I love working with seniors, too. Those of you that knew Jennifer Diamond, when it was around, I was doing some teaching some relaxation classes there. Has anybody heard of the Disney Family Cancer Center? It's in Burbank. I do hypnotherapy there. The second floor is all integrative medicine. I do hypnotherapy. There's massage, acupuncture, acupressure. I think it would be really cool if one day every hospital had integrative medicine, you know, on one of the floors. So I've also been hired by sports teams and individual athletes. I worked at St. Genevieve High School. I worked with the boys and girls basketball team for 3 years. I was their mind coach, so that was kind of cool. Teaching them self-confidence, how to believe in themselves, handle being in slums, all those different types of things. So I do a lot of work with that as well. Definitely take a business card and a brochure. If you're on Facebook, my page is Healing with Hypnotherapy. My website is paulagetty.com. So take a look there to learn more about that. Now, I originally came here to Cancer Support Community in 1997. My husband was diagnosed with leukemia. I came to the classes here, the support groups. It was really, really helpful to me. He passed away in 1999, 2 years later. And I continued coming to the transition and the bereavement group. So this is a great place to come. After that, I went back to school and I became a hypnotherapist. And I became certified in hypnotherapy, certified in therapeutic imagery. I came back and I said, I'm looking to give back. Is there anything I can do here? And they said, hey, we need somebody to teach the relaxation and guided imagery class. So that was in 2006. And so I've been here since then. So a great place to be here. The mind-body connection. So basically, if you have cancer and we're just taking care of the body, you're going for treatments, you're looking to get rid of the cancer, and you don't take care of the mind, you know, they kind of both work together, right? We got to take care of the body during the treatments, but if you got stress and anxiety, that's going to take a toll on the immune system, and you're going to, any symptoms we're dealing with are going to be worse, you can't think straight. So definitely got to look at the mind-body connection. And hypnotherapy is one way to really help you with that mind part of it. So if you are looking to see a hypnotherapist, ask them their training. Okay, we're not licensed. So if you go to somebody and they say, oh, I took a class here or a class there, you want to get somebody who's well trained. I have a degree in psychology. I went to a nationally accredited college of hypnotherapy, Hypnosis Motivation Institute. I took the full year program. I did my internship there, and since then I've taken a ton of workshops and seminars. I've been teaching my own workshops as well. I had my first retreat last year, so I've been doing a lot of different things. I remember I was watching the doctors one time. They said, only get a licensed therapist if you're going to, you know, get some hypnosis, go to a hypnotherapist. And I would say to get somebody well trained in hypnotherapy. Now, I work with a licensed MFT. We refer clients to each other. We work together at times. But if you go to a licensed therapist, you have a fear of needles, and that licensed therapist had a weekend workshop, and they don't know what they're doing, they could actually make that fear worse. So if you're looking for a hypnotherapist, get somebody well-trained in hypnotherapy. More, okay? So I'm talking to everybody here based about cancer, because we're at the Cancer Support Community. But when I'm also referring to the stress and anxiety, it's also caregivers. How many caregivers do we have in here? And how many are dealing with cancer, either had or have cancer in the past? Okay. So I've been a caregiver. I know the stress and anxiety that you're facing too. So as I'm talking about all the stress and anxiety, it's for both. Some I'll go into treatments and stuff a little bit more. But it's definitely caregiver needs help with stress and anxiety as well. So. Now, hypnosis can be used for a lot of different things. I help people quit smoking, lose weight, overcome fears and phobias, fear of heights, water, flying, needles. Like I said, I do a lot of sports hypnosis, help people with self-confidence, self-esteem. And A lot of it, like I said, with cancer, I'll be focusing on today because I'm at the cancer support community. So if you're having issues with dealing with the side effects of chemo or radiation, dealing with pain, can't sleep at night, anxiety going into procedures or surgeries or healing or bereavement or whatever it is, that mind-body connection, that hypnotherapy can really help you with that. Okay? So let me ask you, in this, when I do these workshops, one of the things that's tough is that hypnotherapy is so misunderstood. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the difference between stage hypnosis and hypnotherapy. But oftentimes I say, how many of you can be hypnotized? So how many think you can be hypnotized? Okay. How many think you cannot be hypnotized? Okay. And then how many aren't sure? Okay. Right. Those of you didn't raise your hands. Okay. The truth is, for hypnotherapy, that everyone can be hypnotized, if you want to be. You could come into my office and sit and say, I'm not going to be hypnotized, I'm going to block you. Yeah, you could do that. But for hypnotherapy, everyone can be hypnotized if you want to be, because it's a natural state. We're in several times during the day. Have you ever been driving your car and you miss your exit because your mind's on something else? You're in hypnosis. What about reading a book or watching a movie and you get so involved that you don't hear anything around you, or you feel the same emotions, you're crying or you're laughing? That's hypnosis. Daydreaming. You're in hypnosis. This is kind of just a light state. You know, listen to music, you're kind of zoning out. So you're in hypnosis several times during the day. Now, it's not stage hypnosis. There's no certain depth that you need to go to. So for hypnotherapy, everyone can be hypnotized as long as they want to be, with your permission, okay? It's not stage hypnosis. I've never had anybody bark like a dog in my office. We're not doing any of the entertainment stuff. You don't have to go to any certain depth. For stage hypnosis, about 25% of the population maybe can be hypnotized for that. You do have to go to a certain depth. They want good entertainment subjects, right? So you do have to go to a certain depth for stage hypnosis. Not everybody can be hypnotized for stage hypnosis. And they are looking to hypnotize you for entertainment. For hypnotherapy, everyone can be hypnotized with your permission. In hypnotherapy, there's no certain depth that you need to go to. It's for self-improvement, to help make positive changes in your lives, to help you reach your goals. So if you come in for hypnosis or hypnotherapy session, you're going to hear everything I say. Okay, you're not going to do anything against your morals, values, ethics. There's no certain depth that you need to go to. It's not magic, it's not voodoo, it's not witchcraft. These are all the things that people have said to me, right? And same thing, sometimes people think it's magic. They say, just hypnotize me, make me stop doing that. So it's basically us working together, okay? You're not gonna be stuck in hypnosis. I'm gonna show you the techniques I use to put you into hypnosis and bring you out. But there's a big difference between stage hypnosis and hypnotherapy. So hypnotherapy, everybody can be hypnotized. For hypnotherapy, who can be hypnotized? Everyone, as long as they want to be, okay, you can block yourself too. And when you're in hypnosis, your mind is more open, you're more suggestible, okay? And it's also, when you're in hypnosis, we have access to the subconscious. Let me show you that, okay? So, everybody see okay back there? So I want you to imagine that this is your mind, okay? And when we're born, it's a blank slate. You're not born being confident. You're not born being a negative thinker. We learn that. Now, there is a small part that is pre-wired. That's kind of where fight or flight is located. But for the most part, we learn everything. Now, we're born, and we start to learn by identification, association, response. We identify our mom. We associate that with love. We respond by cuddling, positive experience. We identify a dog who scared us once. We associate that with fear. We respond by staying away, negative experience. We have these positive and negative experiences from the time we're born, and the area that develops is the subconscious mind. Subconscious mind is 88% of your mind. How much is the subconscious mind?
88%.
Make sure everybody's listening. Okay, good. The subconscious mind is your programs. It's your life script. Everything you've learned from your parents, your teachers, it goes down into these programs, and they become our knowns. Now, just because it's negative, sometimes it seems safe and comfortable. Do you ever know somebody that no matter what happens, they find the bad thing about it? Their mind just goes to the negative. God, that's just so, it's so negative. Why do they keep doing that? It's actually safe and comfortable. What about, you know anybody that's in a bad relationship, and then it's like that bad person leaves and another bad person comes in, and you're like, ah, it's so negative. Why do they keep doing that? It's safe, it's comfortable, it's a known. So the subconscious mind, 88%, our programs, our life script, are knowns, okay? The other part of the mind is the conscious mind. The conscious mind is 12%, okay? 12%. Now the conscious mind is your logic, your reasoning, your willpower, and your decision making. Logically, you want to be organized, but subconsciously, you know, you start to do it and then it takes it over the way you always are. What about at the beginning of the year when we use our willpower? We have our New Year's resolutions, right? And they last for about 3 days, okay? And so we're like, why doesn't it work? It's our willpower, that's our 12%. What takes over? The programs, the 88%. So we're trying to get into the subconscious mind, and it's so difficult because what there's here is a critical mind. Right in between these two is a critical mind. The critical mind is a filter. We try to go down there and make changes, and it just gets rejected because it stays with what's safe and comfortable, our programs. With hypnosis, we go in and we disorganize this critical mind. Gives us access to the subconscious. Remember I said when you're in hypnosis, your mind's a little more open. We could go down here and change these negatives to positives, plus we're gonna look to add the positives. You're calm, you're relaxed, you're confident, whatever it is. Now, can we go down, you spend an hour and a half talking to me about all the negatives in your life and have one session and boom, we just changed all the negatives? Probably not, right? But we are dealing, when we do hypnosis, we are dealing with the programs, with the subconscious, which is where we can make the changes. Okay? And sometimes, you know, we can make some changes and it's up to you to continue to reinforce it, so we kind of lock it in. Other times we can do these positives all around it here, and eventually this negative kind of wears away. But the main thing I want you to remember, subconscious mind, 88% of your mind, your programs. Hypnosis is a way to get access to that so we can make those changes. Because most of the time we're just working with this 12% up here. Okay. Any questions on that?
Does that mean that affirmations don't work because you're not hypnotized and they don't go?
Well, you do, even when I do my class on Fridays, I get everybody in a real relaxed state so that we can look to drop them down in here. But sometimes, yeah, we're doing an affirmation. There's more to it. We'll talk about affirmations a little more too. We want to feel it. We want to believe it. We want to see it. So if you don't have that belief and stuff too, so it's a little bit more. But yeah, if we get your mind in an open state and then we do an affirmation, it's more likely to work out there. Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. So let's go and cut that one.